Okay, so this next video is going to be more of a research video, and so I have no idea where it's going to lead or end up or what the sort of overall message is actually going to be. In the last 2 weeks, I've been taking quite a big interest in Robbie Williams. When it comes to favourite artists, you know, I much prefer female artists, and I feel like their songs connect to me and things that I believe because I have a connection with them. Even though the songs were probably written by a bunch of males who I don't actually know, I feel like my connection with them,
the singer,
and the writer's connection with them has kind of linked and joined, hence why they were able to write songs for them that link to me, because I've been channeling energy to them and the writers have been picking up on this energy and somehow it's ended up in their hands. I know sometimes you write a song for one artist and it ends up going to a completely different artist, but then I can kind of explain why there's a better reason why that artist would be suited to that song. I don't know, it's a bit complicated, but because I feel like I've had a bit of a connection with Robbie Williams, whether or not he knows, I don't know, but I kind of feel it. So because of that, I'm kind of going to look into his work to see if there's any sort of hidden messages, or if I could just give my opinions on some of the songs that he's done in the past. I know he was in Take That, and the majority of Take That songs were actually done by Gary Barlow, but like I was saying before, I feel like if I've been feeding him energy, maybe Gary Barlow was able to read off that, hence why Take That failed once Robbie Williams left. No, no. Although, do understand that I'm not always right and maybe I'm wrong about this. This is just a theory. But I do believe that I'm Christ. I do believe that I'm talking to people through songs, through time. Hence, time has no relevance. Hence, I can inspire a song about Robbie leaving even before Robbie left the band. Hence, what I believe I've done here. No, no love ain't here anymore. I'm just making a video to see if I can prove that I'm talking to people, writers, through time, through songs. Talk the way we used to talk. It's true that right now I have more love for Robbie than any other male singer. Hence why there could be some sort of things in his songs or in the Take That songs, even though my favourite singer was actually Robbie, not Gary. Listen, oh listen. I haven't really gone through the songs yet, and I know a lot of the songs are about love, and therefore I know a lot of the songs might be inspired also by people they were dating at the time, or can just be general to a lot of people, hence don't just match with me, or things that I've gone through. Also, sometimes songs were written over a course of a few weeks or months, hence the inspiration behind different lines or different sections can actually come from completely different places. Hence I could say some lines mean something, and then later on in the song it kind of contradicts and proves my theory wrong. I know that's going to happen a few times, because I feel like when people get inspired, you know, some verses are inspired by some things and some verses are inspired by something different. Anyway, I'm treating some of the lines a bit like a jigsaw puzzle, mostly just because I want to say things. For example, it's so honey, why don't you beg me to stay for love? If Robbie is my favourite singer, surely I'd want him to stay in the band, because that's where his fame started. But honestly, my opinion is that the band kind of overshadows him, because the songs are mostly sung by Gary Barlow. I've looked on Wikipedia about the main singers who sing on all the different songs, and it really was like Gary, 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 with a few other names dropping in every now and then, but Gary was the lead on most of them. And when I was briefly going over the songs, I found it really kind of annoying, because I wanted to see more Robbie, and Gary Barlow just kind of took over, and he sings the lead in most of the songs, and I found it quite annoying, whereas I think Robbie stands out so much better when he's just on his own. Although I think there was a good reason why he was in Take That in the first place, which is that Robbie, when he was younger, did have a big ego, was a massive player, liked having sex with strangers, which is something that I'll never understand, and so him being overshadowed by Gary Barlow probably was best for his ego, because it was probably way too big at the time. But yeah, as he's got older, he's become more mature. I definitely like him more that he's found Ida, because I think she's made him a better person. The problem is, because he's got Ida, I know I shouldn't have too much love for him. It's a catch-23. But anyway, that's the point of this video. One, to just give my interpretation and just talk about it, basically, for anyone that's just interested in wanting to hear things that I have to say. I'm not going to bother recording myself into this, because I don't think this video is going to be, like, amazingly great or anything. I've just got nothing to do, so that's the main reason why I'm doing it. I know out of all the Spice Girls, Victoria was my least favourite, and when I started looking into it, I kind of realised that she actually got all the booby lines, or the lines that weren't that great. You're sailing out in the wrong direction. direction. And suggested that the person who gave her those lines wasn't that into her. And I feel like that was done because my energy towards her was less, hence when the writers were writing songs with these people, she would always end up with the sort of less good lines, should I say. And right now I kind of want to know if the same can be done within Take That songs, because I do prefer Robbie Williams much more than Gary Barlow. Not that there's anything wrong with Gary, it's just, you know, each to his own. I'm more a Robbie fan. And I think in some of Gary's videos, he comes off more of like a puppy dog. I'll explain what I mean in the video. Don't you want me to go? So honey, why don't you beg me to stay for love? After Robbie left the band, I didn't really care if Take That failed, because they weren't really my favourite band. And I think a lot of Gary's songs are just really needy. All I do each night is pray. You know, like a lost little puppy just saying, Ona, love me, Ona, love me. It's insulting, yes, but I'm sure if you hear the songs, you'll kind of agree with me. All I do each night is pray. Out of all the boy bands that came out in the 90s, Take That is probably my least favourite. The time for change is here. And it's weird because Robbie Williams is kind of my favourite artist right now. I would have said will.i.am and Justin and then him third, which is what I said a few months ago. But I only give that order, why? Because I prefer Black Eyed Peas more than NSYNC, and I prefer NSYNC more than Take That. And Take That is probably one of my least favourite bands, and I've kind of decided to explore the reasons why it's my least favourite band that were famous in the 90s. Because if I am God, you know, I know the beginning from the end. Hence, I would have known that Robbie Williams would end up being my favourite male singer. If I compare him to female singers, he'll probably be like 100 on my list. But that's only because I prefer female singers, because I connect with them far better. But anyway, it wouldn't make sense to put my favourite male singer in my least favourite boy band. So I thought I'd just explore the reasons why it's my least favourite. I think though the main reason is that Take That really started in 1992. I was only 5 years older this time, so out of all the boy bands, Take That was probably my least favourite, because I didn't like 80s bands very much, and I feel like Take That was kind of a cross between 80s bands and 90s bands. You know, there was a point where it suddenly started changing from something I didn't like into something that I did like, which really started in around 1995. I didn't like bands of the 80s because I felt like they were a bit chavvy and stuff, and I do feel like some of the early work of Take That do more fall into the sort of 80s styled category. Whereas boy bands later on in the 90s started becoming a bit more well-dressed and more my type, basically. But yeah, I just want to explore this. Like, a lot of the 80s bands promoted drugs, carefree lifestyles, sex with lots of different people. I think most of them were a really bad influence on how people should be. And I think most of them had their priorities wrong. I know Robbie has got involved in drugs and sex and a bad way of life, but at the same time, the 90s boy bands didn't promote this kind of lifestyle as much. They did it, but they kind of hid it more in the background. Whereas bands like Oasis and things in the 70s, they really did promote sex, drugs, smoking, and all sorts. Whereas 90s bands have kind of cleared up their act. I don't like this Heaven song. Oh, I see heaven in your eyes for me. Yeah. Oh, baby. Because it kind of reminds me of Saved by the Bell, only it's kind of mixed that attitude with love, and they're not the same things, you know. It's fun, yeah, but it's just not really my song. And I hate the lead singer's sort of look on this. It's kind of like punk, only not extreme punk, like loose punk. And I think Gary looks a little bit like a bully in this video. You know, the type of guy that would steal pocket money off geeky kids. I don't know, that's the imagery that it comes off. I'm not a fan of this song. But I do find it interesting how Robbie says this. I thought I found love with somebody else's girl, yeah. And it's strange because I have a sort of relationship. Okay, it's like an IBF, which is code for imaginary boyfriend. So I don't know if Martin really likes me, but I feel like I'm supposed to be with him and spiritually with him. But I also feel like I'm having a little bit of an affair with Robbie, in the sense that I've gone through a lot of his songs and I felt like they've connected with me in some weird way. And if there's somebody calling me on, she's the one. And your Jesus really died for me. And then Jesus really tried for me. And so it's interesting how he was given this line.
All the way through my 20s, I just wanted somebody to fix me. I wanted somebody to come in my life and, you know, I'd heard the songs that take my breath away. And you're at school and you think somebody's going to come and take your breath away. And they're going to fill in all of the blanks and you're going to live happily ever after. So I set about trying to find her, whoever she was going to be, for a decade, and I didn't. Walking around feeling so broken.
Although I do want to point out that I am not attracted to Robbie at this age. He looks like a fun guy, but at the same time, he also looks like someone that would sleep with 10 different girls in 1 week and only be proud of the fact that he slept with 10 girls. He wouldn't necessarily care about the quality of the person of whom he slept with. That's the kind of vibe I feel from him at this age. If I can get him to listen to me, I would tell him that it's not about the number of girls you sleep with, but rather it's more important how much you care about the person that you're sleeping with. And likewise, they wouldn't really like him for this attitude, and so this could be why he's built up some sort of insecurities. But because you spent most of your life not understanding that, I don't actually want to be with you. I thought you'd soon be my girl, but my imagination was running wild. I feel that way too. Like I'm having an imaginary affair against my imaginary boyfriend. I wouldn't listen to a single soul, deep in a sense of denial. But anyway, I want to point that out because I do not promote free sex. I think sex should be about love and commitment, and I feel like this song just doesn't promote that. But it tries to trick people by making out that it does know what love and commitment mean. Only if you listen to how this chorus is sung, you know, it sounds awful and cringe and just... You're the only one in my life, baby! You know, it sounds that bad. It's almost like a piss take of a love song. The words are right, but everything else is so wrong. This next song has to be the worst of the lot. Yeah, you're right, it's absolutely awful. Definitely not for me. It's got this whole 80s vibe. This is supposed to be 92. Come on, move on. Calculate your needs. My needs are for men to be manly and masculine. But what the fuck are you doing here? Skipping or something? Do you want some pigtails with that? I think whoever decided on that move should be fired. Exactly what I said. Make the 90s different from the 80s. Don't decide till you see how you are. Yeah, I've seen the other boy bands groan. They are way better than this. You need to up your game. Once you've tasted love, it's just the beginning of a new world. Yep, bring in the new world now, because this old world sucks. One thing I noticed about this song is that it's called, you know, Once You've Tasted Love, but the member that I like the most is Robbie, and he's barely shown. Like, there's only, like, one close-up clip of him. For all the other clips, he's just kind of like a background dancer. That, to me, seems like it's hinting that he's not the one that I need to find. It's Gary that takes the lead throughout the whole song. But he's not my type, and I definitely know that. But it does make me wonder, was this his choice, or was this just his manager's choice? I'm not too sure. But I don't like this video. Although I can see a kind of connection with all the different names. So you've got Howard. When I was born, there was this boy who looked very similar to me, born just a few hours after me. His name was Charles Howard, and we looked like identical twins for the first 3 years of our life, apart from him being a boy, of course. And strangely enough, right now, he actually looks like this. The next name is Robbie. Technically, I do feel like he's robbed my heart a little bit. Hence why Robbie is an appropriate name for him. Jason is the name of the only guy that I've ever properly dated in the first few months of January 2019. And Mark happens to be the same name as my godfather. And Take That's manager in the 90s was Martin Nigel Smith. Martin is the name of the person that I believe that I'm meant to be with, my soulmate. And Nigel's the name of my dad. It's a little weird how I can connect with all these names. The only name I can't connect with is Gary. And unfortunately, out of this group, I do think I like him least, to be honest. I mean, I do not like this look or this hairstyle. And you're going to notice that throughout this video, I am making it kind of obvious that I prefer Robbie to Gary. Not how he was in the past, because I know he was a complete womanizer and loved having sex with strangers, which is something that I would never understand, nor support. But, you know, if that's his thing, then whatever. But when it comes to Gary, I find it quite annoying because I feel like he just hugs all the limelight. And Robbie's just as good a singer. That's another song that I really don't like. I don't like it because it's not true. You can't fall in love with someone in a minute. You can get to know them in a short time and you can start missing them, you know, a few hours, days later, but it doesn't take a minute. What does take a minute though is having an orgasm. So it feels like you've confused love with sex. That's the main reason why I don't like this song. And again, going back to the puppy dog scenario, you know, this does sound like something a dog would say. It only takes a minute. Hump, 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 orgasm, then the dog's part. You also kind of look like a sort of punky boxer, and it's just not my type. Another song I don't like is A Million Love Songs Later. A million words just trying to make the love song of the year. That line kind of indicates that all you really want is a number one song. The rest of the lines just sound quite desperate and like you failed in a massive way. A million love songs later. Here I am trying to tell you. I mean, why would you have to write a million love songs just to tell someone that you love them? A man who's trying to say three words, the words that make me scared. If you have to write a million love songs for the person you love, realize that it's a love song. Well, it kind of just means that you failed at making love songs. But then again, if you think that this is a love song, I think you have failed at making love songs, so you're right. Million love songs later. I guess now it's time for me to give up. And this song's weird because it's like you predict in the song that your love songs are awful. Look into the future now. This is what I see. Million chances pass me by. Million chances to hold you. Take me back, take me back. You are back when you were writing the song, you just didn't realize. Hide away from all my truths through the light I see. But you did, because you said that this is what will happen in the future, so you should have known what will happen in the future and not done it, but anyway, whatever. I'm not going to go through all your songs, I'm only going to go through the songs that you've got music videos to, so the next one is... Why can't I wake up with you, so you're there when I open my eyes? Baby, why can't I wake up with you? So yeah, this is another song about you loving someone who doesn't love you back. I think you just give up at this point. I don't like this song because I think it's just too needy. I don't like the other songs, but I do love this song. I feel like the vibe changes when Robbie sings the sort of lead parts. Spirits move me. And I think that he's more connected to me than you are, and that's exactly what this song says. You're my lifeline, angel of my lifetime. It's true, I believe that I've kind of inspired most of your work, or your best work, should I say. Not all of it, only 20%, but that 20% is usually a lot better. Baby, I want you come. And again, the chorus sounds absolutely awful on this. It sounds flat or something, I don't know. I'm not musically inclined to tuning and stuff, but it just sounds awful, and it kind of indicates that they don't really like me as much as you did or do, or I don't know. It's a good song though. I love the verse words. Why? Because it kind of backs up what I was saying in my last videos about Robbie to Robbie, about how I'm going to show you some magic by saying things and linking them to songs of the past, making it seem like perhaps things I'm saying in the present are actually inspiring things of the past. And now, in your past, you're singing about how, is this magic? Let me feel the wonder of all of you. Could it be magic now? I guess you could argue that I only made that video because I heard this video and I was trying to deliberately fulfill this prophecy, but to be honest, I'm not a fan of Take That, so I can't remember which songs they actually sung unless I actually look it up. And unless the video has a music video to it, I can't actually tell the difference between the voices, hence I wouldn't be able to tell who's singing what. So I'd only know who sings what by looking at the music video, hence why I'm only analysing the music videos. And if someone would have asked me who sung this song, I wouldn't have necessarily known, because my memory is really bad. And to be honest, I just like the song. I don't really care who sings it, but it does seem very coincidental how the person who sings it happens to be the person that I made a video about, saying how I want to show them some magic about how I'm inspiring things of the past. Could this be the magic? Well, you're definitely a lot more famous now than you were back then. River, reach our sons and daughters, the bushes. What are you doing it for? What are you doing it for? What are you doing it for? In this video, I'm trying to prove that I'm inspiring things of the past, but to be honest, I don't know if I'm being very successful in this video because they could be talking about a lot of things. And I'm pretty sure that when Robbie was talking about could it be magic, I'm pretty sure he's referring to sex. So the possibility that he's talking about something that Christ is going to do in the future is probably very unlikely, but I feel like although he would have had different motivations, the Spirit or God would have had a different motivation. I know proving that is very hard, but I think some of Take That's most recent work is a bit more evidential of what I'm trying to prove or make accusations about, really. I can't really prove anything unless the singers themselves actually back me up on stuff. But if I am Christ, I believe that it's my destiny in the future that they will help me and they will support me. And right now I'm just bored out of my mind, hence making videos. Everything changes but you. So right now I'm analysing all their songs, a whole lifetime worth of their songs. I've only been looking at their songs for the last few months, with a few months break in between. And yeah, I'm pretty much the same person, I haven't changed. But they have, because their albums are released years apart. We've said goodbye. Well, it is true, you did leave Take That. Just one more kiss before I have to go. I believe by kisses you mean song inspirations, songs such as this one. And like he said, it was done before you left Take That. Hey girl, I know the situation changed. Yeah, well, you are married with kids now, and I might have Martin. Still don't know yet. Either that or I'm just happily single. And so much is new. Yeah, nothing's changed. I can still inspire your songs, even if the song was done 30 years ago. We're a thousand miles apart. Yeah, 30 years you mean. You know every single day I'll be thinking about you. Yes, I've looked at a lot of your songs in three other videos that I made about you. And based on that, I do think this is a little bit true. You know I love you. I would like to think that you have love for me, but at the same time, I've never met you. Maybe if I did meet you face to face, you'd just be like, what the fuck are you on? But hey, whatever. The rumor's true, know that there've been others. Has there been other girls or other rumors? I'm not too sure. I think it could be saying both. No, it's both in your case. You've been with a lot of others, I know that. What can I do? I tell you, baby, they don't mean a thing. Well, that's kind of the biggest problem, you know, you shouldn't sleep with girls that don't mean a thing to you. Also saying this is a massive insult to the other 100 girls that you've slept with. Or is it 200? Do you think it's closer to 100 or 200? That's a question that I want to ask you. Or maybe you're just showing off with numbers because you think it makes you a better man or something. Not that it does. I know Martin told me that he slept with 100 girls, but because he said that, I mean, anything nice he's ever said to me kind of means nothing, because I bet he said the same thing to those 100 girls. Now girl, don't go. You sleeping with 100 girls is actually the main reason why I wouldn't want to sleep with you. And the fact that those girls don't mean a thing to you kind of just proves what an idiot you are for sleeping with them in the first place. I'll be home soon, back in your arms to hear you say that. And they zoom into the cross there. Yes, I believe that I'm the Christ on that cross. Everything changes but you. I'll spend every single day. Sit and talk to God, and he just laughs at my plan. My head speaks a language I don't understand. I was there to witness.
Candice is in a business. She wants the boys to notice.
How are you going to explain that to your wife, that you've had an affair with God? Although she'd be happy to know that I'm asexual, hence have no sexual desire. It's all spiritual. I love music as well.
My only commandment was thou shalt not get married and thou shalt not have children. And that was...
And you've broken both.
I broke both, but I fell in love. And here we are now, 10 years later, 2 children in, 7 years of marriage. She's transformed my life.
The next song I'm going to move on to is the song Pray. But again, this is another example of a failed love song. I believe that you've written all of the Take That songs. But yeah, the ones that you write for Robbie are way better than the ones that you write for yourself for some reason. I mean, look at the words.
When the time grew near for me to show my love.
When time gets near for me to show my love, the longer I stayed away for hiding from a word, I need to hear now. I don't think I'll hear it again. So I guess you're trying to express love, only you're hiding from it. You need to hear it, only you don't think you hear it again. But the nights were always warmer with you, holding you right by my side, but morning always comes too soon. I don't know, it doesn't really make much sense because you can still hug people in the morning, but you're kind of indicating that it comes too soon, hence you don't get to express feelings you wanted to express. I don't know, but it's not really a love song because you can express feelings of love in the morning. So how can morning coming too soon prevent you from expressing your love? And the chorus is way exaggerated.
All I do each night is pray. Oh, hoping that I'll be a part of you again someday.
It almost sounds like a husband who severely beats his wife, but then after goes on about how, oh no, I really do love you, look, I pray for you every night, don't leave me, when in reality it's just a matter of time before he turns against her again. It either sounds like that, or it sounds like the puppy dog thing. You know, I love you, I love you, I love you, just give me food, 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 food. And the second part of the chorus goes, all I do each night is think of all the times I close the door to keep my love within. Again, if this is supposed to be a love song, then why is your love song all about not exposing love, not revealing love, keeping it within and not, you know, showing it? You know, I think you look much better in this video. I feel the imagery you have in this video is much better, but still, it's not my thing. Also, the woman in this is a tree. It's like you're trying to express love to a woman, only you've got the woman dressed up like a tree, hence it doesn't really make much sense because you shouldn't really love trees because trees don't love you back. I think the imagery of this really kind of shows you're trying to love God, but because you've portrayed this God figure, this woman, as a tree, kind of shows that she doesn't really like you back. And I do like you as a person, I just, yeah, I don't have that same connection with you as I do with Robbie. And that's, I guess, the purpose of this video. I believe that I'm feeling a connection with Robbie and not so much you, and I'm trying to show it within the music because the lines that you sing kind of indicate that you have no love with this person you're connecting to, or have little love, should I say. Whereas the lines that Robbie gets seems to indicate that he is actually having an affair with Christ. I've also noticed that out of everyone, he's the only one that actually gets caught up in this tree. Take that. Ba-dum-bum. Sorry, I had to say it. Each to his own.
Hoping that I'll be a part of you again someday.
there when I open my eyes. Baby, why can't I wake up with you?
Whatever I said, whatever I did, I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good.
You're a nice person, but these songs aren't really love songs. Like, you can't really say to a girl, love me because I'm cold and all alone. These words kind of sound a bit desperate and makes you less attractive. And you seem quite needy in all of them.
I need you so much, but I don't think you really need me.
Listen, oh listen, I don't want to let go.
When it comes to guys, I'd prefer guys to offer me things rather than guys just expect things from me. And I do feel like with your songs, it's all about your need for someone else rather than your ability to help someone else.
Million love songs later.
That's much better. That's my favourite song of yours. And yeah, I think you're really attractive in that song because it's sung in a sort of masculine way. I prefer that. Okay, yes, it's a message to your partner saying your partner should give, but it also feels like you're giving too in this because you can kind of feel that energy from it. Give me this because I'm a man and I need it.
Give me what I need.
Rather than, give me this because I'm a puppy dog and I need it. And I love this song.
This is a first class journey from the gods to the Son of Man. You're at the gates of human evolution, don't you understand? Why don't you understand? Help me escape this feeling of insecurity.
Yes, the next song on my list is Relight My Fire. It's the fourth song on the second album. And yes, it goes back to his insecurities and his need and needs and...
I need you so much, but I don't think you really need me. I've got to say I only dream of you.
You know, I had no idea that Take That wrote the song. I've heard this song so many times, but I thought this was a 70s band. I'm sure there was a 70s band that did this song. Is this like a remake or something? Because I swear it was like ABBA or something did this. Yeah, I've looked it up now. It was Dan Hartman. And because I love this song, Hartman is an appropriate name. But anyway, it's next on the list to have a music video, so I have to talk about it. It's all about Relight the Fire.
Relight the fire. Your love is my only desire.
Hence, it's talking about a fire that hasn't been lit yet. And back then, his songs were kind of awful. Although I love this song, but Gary didn't write it, so maybe that's why. I think some of your songs are connecting with me, but not necessarily in a good way. They're more non-love songs.
Like a thief in the night, you took away the love that I knew.
E.g., you might have thought that they were love songs, but I'm kind of taking them back and saying they're not.
Relight my fire.
Okay, I'm going to try. From this point on, I'm going to have another closer look at the songs that you do from this point onwards. Maybe there'll be a better connection.
Turn back the time to the days when our love was new. Do you remember?
Inspiring things through time is exactly what I think I can do. So yeah, you got that right. Even though this song was actually written in the 70s by someone else.
No matter what was happening, I was there with you.
It does get kind of confusing, right?
But if we all stand up for what we believe.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'd like. I'd like you to stand with me and kind of back up the things that I say, the things that I believe in terms of what I can do and the fact that I'm Christ.
Maybe live within our possibilities.
Live with possibilities? Well, yeah. If I can do this, then maybe other people can be gods too. Or if I can do this, what else can I do?
The world would be wild for the dream.
Yeah, the world will be amazed. They'll finally stop believing in Jesus, this fictional thing that can just walk on water and do pretty much shit all, because it's not actually real.
So baby, don't turn away, listen to what I got. my mind.
Gonna rock my mind.
I celebrated glory,
but that was not to be.
Yeah, sorry, I have said quite a lot of negative things about you. And when I was talking about all boy bands last summer, I deliberately didn't mention you.
In the twist of separation, you excelled at being free. Can't you find a little room inside for me? Whatever I said, whatever I did, I didn't mean it. I just want you back for good.
I think you just need to be a little bit more masculine. Like, you're a little bit like Ronan Keaton, only he has that masculine quality. And I don't know why. You know, I think he really works as a solo artist, whereas I think you kind of work best as a band.
Got a fist of pure emotion, got a head of shattered dreams. Gotta leave it all behind now.
I'm sure you can evolve, change and grow, maybe you'll be better. But from what I've seen so far, I think you're best as a group, because I think you're a little bit weak on your own. Although having said that, I don't think I've actually listened to any of your songs that you sing on your own. I might get around to doing it afterwards, we'll see.
Set it all, nothing to say at all. Nothing to say.
Yeah, Robbie was in my direction, sorry. I had a client tell me that he thought Gary Barlow was more famous than Robbie, and that was kind of what inspired me to make this video, because I had no idea that Gary Barlow, in some people's minds, was seen as the more famous one, because I've barely heard of you.
Talking here for days and days and days. Set it all, nothing to say. Still hanging from a love I lost. I'm feeling your frustration.
Yeah, my frustration is that I seem to be inspiring things even if people have no clue who I am. If I don't like someone, or don't like them as much as someone like Robbie, I know you're in a band, hence you were working together, and you know, I do have more feelings for him than you, and maybe some of, or a lot of your songs have been inspired from that lack of love towards you. You know, that's just a theory.
When we were young, we were drawn to whoever could keep us together and bound by the heavens above. And we tried to survive, traveling at the speed of love. Whoa, when we were young, when we adored the fabulous. Whoa, when we were young, we were the foolish, fearless, never knowing the cost of what we paid. Letting someone else be strong. Whoa, when we were young. In a moment of grace.
The name Anna means grace, and yeah, I do believe that you two were bound together through the music, but your music was both inspired by me only. Robbie's been inspired by my feelings towards him, and you've been inspired by my lack of feelings towards you. Kind of an interesting contrast. And like the song says, I'm the one that has to pay the price, because I'm the one that has to be strong, because it's my strength that's inspiring this. And the only reason why I'm alive right now is because I haven't killed myself. Why I haven't killed myself yet, though, is a complete mystery, because I've been in a living nightmare ever since this stuff has started. And I've been having thousands of people do things about me behind my back for years and years and years, and I still don't know if you know about this or not, because you're not talking to me, no one's talking to me. So it's incredibly hard and frustrating.
Long live the faith.
Incredibly hard and frustrating. The worst thing about this is that there's no one that supports me or believes me. My parents don't, friends I don't have any friends. My sister doesn't, and everyone who watches my YouTube videos doesn't understand and is mad, and usually responds by saying something that makes no sense whatsoever. But at the same time, I still feel like it's happening. There's nothing I can do to stop it. I feel like things that I'm saying now are inspiring songs of the past. Songs such as this one. For example, I've just told him to change and be a bit more manly.
Don't be too hard on my emotions. Start over again. I know you wanna be my salvation, the one that I can always depend. I'll try to be strong, believe me, I'm trying to move on. It's complicated, but understand me.
Yes, it's complicated. I know people aren't gonna believe me, but if this guy comes forward and says, you know what, I think she's right. You know, in this clip, he looks up to power lines. I guess that's how I'm connecting to people, through some sort of spiritual power. If he supports me on this, then people are more likely to believe me. Without him, people are just going to think that I'm mad. And this video is now too long, so I'm going to have to do a two-part series to this.